Morning, world. Tibby Trev here. Another beautiful day up here in paradise. God, I love living up here in Queensland, but yep, the nights can be cold. Roll the intro.
Hi, Tibby Trev here, and welcome to my channel. Hope you get something out of it.
Right, our world. Another beautiful day up here in paradise, and yeah, the nights are certainly getting cold, but we're certainly saved by the days, so that's pretty cool. So, prezzies in the mail. But this time it's one I've bought. Well, it's two I've bought for myself. So I only bought these 2 days ago off a Facebook model page. I can't remember which one. I'm in about two or three model pages now on Facebook. Oh, you certainly got the sticky tape well put together. These two came up and I just sort of like, yep, I've got to have them. So I saw these two models online, I thought, yep, I've got to have that one. And then I saw the one that came up straight after on the same page, said, yep, got to have that one too. I've nearly finished the Simon Ellington Western Star model. That's pretty close to being done now. But these two showed up on one of the Facebook pages and I could not say no. So what have we got? We've got a Honda 754 cop bike. And so look what we got here, come on. Now, I used to ride Honda 754s, so I'm a bit partial to them, especially this model, the early K series, 70s, excuse me. Especially the early 70s K series, so it looks like it's all going to be in Japanese. There's our destruction sheet. Okay, there's our destruction sheet, and it does have English on it, which is pretty good. The decal sheet. Look, got some good lenses there. I'd be very surprised if any of these decals actually work. They look so old, they look like they're going to come apart in the box. I'll have to look and see if I can find a year build date. So that'd be our police accessories. Nice lot of chrome. More chrome. Oh my God, heaps of chrome, lots of parts. Oh, I'm going to have the same trouble with these wheels that I had with the other Honda 754 I built, where the wheels and tyres were just an absolute pain in the ass. We've got white cabling and we've got black cabling, we've got more chrome and we've got more framework and we've got something out of the box. I'm not sure what that is, but we'll find out. Oh, looking forward to building this one. This will be a good model to build. I had a hell of a lot of trouble with the wheels and tyres on one of the 754 models I built. That was a Japanese built one. The tyres just would not go on the rims properly. That was another 754 model, but I don't know what brand, I can't remember. So rightio, the 754 model, really looking forward to that. And this one, I also couldn't turn up. These good size. Now, what scale are these two? Quickly, we've got a scale on these. I think they're like a 1/8 scale or something like that. 1/8 scale, so they'll be big models. And we've also got the Honda Baldor 900. Same thing, the decals. It'll be interesting if they work. Our destruction sheet. Most of it's in Japanese, but that's all right. Some black, lots of chrome, not chrome, gold chains I'll be doing again. More chrome, lights, good set of glass, good size frame. Same thing with the wheels and tires. Oh, we've even got springs and we've got special glue. These are two very, very cool models. I'll certainly be looking forward to getting into building these. The decals will always be a worry if they're going to come off the sheets properly. There we go. Baldor 900 and the K-Series 754 Honda cop bike. Wow. I will really, really be looking forward to getting into those. Now, those weren't presents. I actually bought these models. I found them on one of the Facebook model pages. I'm in about three different model pages now, and a lot of the same models show up on this, all the same pages, but there are a few there that actually show up that aren't on the other pages. So these were a really good score. $126 for the two models delivered. So that model and that model posted up from Brisbane, $126. I think that's an absolute bargain. Some of these models on their own, if you go and buy this out of a toy shop or somewhere like that, it may be a Japanese brand, but if you go and buy any of these sort of models at 1/8 scale out of a toy shop, you're looking close to $70, $80 per model. So let's get back to the boat for a minute and what's going on there. So I did a flying run over to Childers the other day in the boat to go and grab some naughty sticks. I've got a friend supposedly coming down today, maybe having a campfire tonight. I'm not really sure what's going on there. So anyway, I flew over to Childers the other day and grabbed some more naughty sticks, took the boat over, and I mean, I flew over. It absolutely went like a Trojan. I passed a couple of cars. I was up to 70, 80 mile an hour in a few spots, passing a few cars where I could. Apart from that rattle in the motor, you wouldn't even know something was wrong. And she just cruised along beautifully. I haven't checked the water and oil yet, but she was cruising beautifully. Now, I did make you mention about buying a ute, and I made the fatal mistake of putting up a beautiful XR8 down in Victoria for about 20 grand and saying that, you know, I might be looking around for a ute while the boat's off the road. And I got flooded with all these emails, and thank you, JC, and everyone else for sending the emails and stuff. And I'm looking at these utes, and like, my eyes are rolling back in my head because I'm scrolling down to the prices, and they're pretty up there. So when I put the call out there that I might want a ute, I didn't really think it was going to, I wasn't really expecting the emails that came through, and I certainly wasn't expecting the prices on the emails that were coming through. And basically, with my budget going through all the utes that I saw and all the pages, and with my funds and budget, the only thing I could probably afford in a running ute would be like a burned out, broken down Bravo B2000 or something, would need a shitload of work to keep it on the road while I keep my car on the road. And someone also made a really, really good comment. They basically said, oh, because, you know, I showed that $20,000 ute way out of my price range, and sort of looking around $2,000-$4,000 mark, and realised the utes that I wanted to get way above that. And someone made a really good comment, said, imagine if you spent that much money, like, you know, around the 14 upwards money, said, imagine if you spent that much money on the boat, what you'd have. I was like, holy shit, the penny kind of dropped. Why am I, you know, one, I can't afford a $20,000 ute. I just can't. Finances don't allow it. I can't even afford a $15,000 ute. I mean, it'd be nice, but I can't. Excuse me. And like I said, my budget pretty much allows for a run-down, broken, burnt-out Mazda fucking B250. That's about all I can afford. So I don't know what I'm going to do about going down that path. But after driving the boat yesterday and that guy saying, sorry, after driving the boat the other day and that bloke just making a comment, if you're going to spend that much money on a ute, which I'm not, but if you're going to spend that much money on a ute, imagine putting that much money into the boat. Like, he's fucking right, you know. I'm not really sure. Look, I don't know what's going on with the car. It drives perfectly. Starts and idles, everything runs perfectly. It is only when I stick the boot in it makes that noise. It's hard to believe. It is a exhaust load burnt out. Honestly, don't know anymore. I really don't think it's a flexi plate problem. I don't know what's going on. The car's almost running too nice to have a chewed out lobe. I don't know what a chewed out. I know what a chewed out lobe sounded like the last time mine went, and it sure as shit doesn't sound like my motor running today. So, is there something else going on in there? I haven't got my rocker cover gaskets in yet. They should be arriving today. I've got someone, like I said, coming down, might be here for a couple of days, so obviously no work's going to happen on the car around that time. And yeah, they're kind of both in the naughty corner at the moment anyway. So anyway, Worlds, yeah, I think I was overshooting the mark when I said I wanted to go ute hunting. My price range is not the price range of all the utes that were sent to me. And like I said, I'd be lucky to afford a bummed out Mazda Bravo T-shirt. I'd be lucky to even afford a bummed out Mazda Bravo B250 with lots of work needed to keep that on the road. So, but anyway, Worlds, at this stage, I'm sort of still ute hunting, but certainly not in the price range that people were sending me. That's a bit extreme. And like that guy said, if I'm going to spend that much money on a ute, why don't I pour that much money into the boat? So, I'm not real sure what to do. I've got to do other things like get up on the roof and start sealing that up while there's no rain around. That's a project to be done. It is winter time at the moment. I've got the shark car show coming up in August, so whether I just limp the boat around for the time being, I am going to do the rocker cover test, pull the rocker covers off and go through all the valve train and make sure there is no problem there. Once I work out where the problem is, like, you know, have I got a done lifter or something like that, I'll make my decision after that about what I do next. But right now, the boat is a shopping trolley around town. It will get me to Bundy and back. It's proven that it flew over to Chilton back the other day and it just ran like a charm. And I said the only time it ever made that noise is when I stuck the boot into it at high RPM. And as I'm passing the car, I just take the foot off the accelerator and coast, and she brought me straight up to speed. It's not lacking any power. It's actually going like a Trojan. So for something that has a burnt out lobe, probably shouldn't be running that good. But anyway, I'm not really sure what I'm going to do with the boat at this stage. Anyway, I've got to get the rocker covers off, go through all the valve trains, check everything out, see if I can find a problem. If there's no problem there, I'm going to have to start looking somewhere else for the problem, and maybe a compression test and stuff like that further down the track. So, but anyway, worlds, today's video is about unboxing the next two models. And once I get the Simon Allington Western Star built, I'll be jumping in and doing these. So anyway, like I said, $126 posted, delivered for those two. Absolutely brilliant. And I certainly will be looking forward to putting them together. So anyway, worlds, stay safe, keep your knees in the breeze, and I will catch you later. Bye.